The Somalia president received a warm embrace on arrival at State House Nairobi, just as Kenya has embraced the Somalia refugees for over two decades. But Kenya seems to have had enough of being its brother's keeper, and so President Uhuru Kenyatta and high-ranking officials got down to the business of the day with his Somalia counterparts. Kenya has already stated that the Dadaab camp must be closed by November this year. The Somalia president, on his part, however, says the repatriation must be voluntary.
Mine is just to assure you, Mr. President, that Kenya will continue to stand shoulder to shoulder with Somalia, indeed, as we combat mutual threats to our peace and stability, largely the threat of Al-Shabaab.
My gratefulness for the generosity of the people of Kenya under your leadership for over extended more than two decades now by receiving these people and hosting them in a respectful manner.
The talks were cordial, but even after 3 years of deliberations, the two sides failed to reach a conclusion. Kenya has hosted the Somalia refugees for 25 years and now wants them back in Somalia, saying that the Dadaab camp has been used by the Al-Shabaab terror group as a hideout to plan and execute attacks on Kenyan soil.
You can always count on Kenya.
The Somalia president on Monday visited Dadaab camp, where he declared his country was ready to receive the refugees, but expressed reservations over a forced repatriation. The two presidents are expected to continue talks on the contentious refugee issue this Wednesday.